right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Ontario Super Series. Our opening contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Sydney, Australia, weighing in at 210 pounds, Sam Osborne.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Ontario Super Series live from Battle Arts Academy. Unbelievable, man. I can't believe it. The three top promotions in Ontario are all assembled under one roof. We're talking about Border City Wrestling right here tonight, represented by the one and only, my commentary partner, Scott D'Amore.
Well, George, it's certainly a sure pleasure to have me here. Besides,
and his opponent.
Let's go to the ring announcer.
From the dairy section, weighing in at 175 pounds, the Ice Cream Machine!
Ladies and gentlemen, a big opening card. Battle Arts Academy, their talent, doing their thing. Of course, Destiny Wrestling, two superstars, the Playboy, taking on the Destiny World Champion. I'm referring to Psycho Mike Rollins. That's going to be a big one.
You know, we haven't even got the opening contest started here, Ice, and you're already trying to put your guys over, trying to put Destiny above Border City Wrestling.
No, come on.
And Battle Arts, it's sickening, it's your style, but it's completely accepted because that's what you do.
Wow. All right, let me rephrase. Ladies and gentlemen, of course, from Border City Wrestling, he is the prototype of professional wrestling in North America and unbelievable talent. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm referring to none other then Tyson Dukes. He will be here. One of the number one cruiserweights in all of Canada. Brett Banks, also representing Border City Wrestling. Some of the biggest in North America are here. And of course, Battle Arts Academy, the Battle Arts Champion. I'm talking about Randy Rain.
Randy Rain, an unbelievable athlete. He's here. You've got all three champions. You've got Psycho Mike Rollins, the Destiny Heavyweight Champion. You've got Randy Rain, who's the Battle Arts Champion. You got Cody Diener, the leader of the Diener Dynasty. It makes me sick, but he's BCW's champion. All three of them in the house here tonight. Nice. But we've got our contest.
Wait a minute. Did you just say the Border City Wrestling Champion, Cody Diener, is here tonight?
The Border City Wrestling
Champion,
Cody Diener, is here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first contest, the first matchup, Sam Osborne.
I gotta tell you, I really like this Buck Machine.
Buck Machine. He's actually being referred to as the Ice Cream Machine.
The Ice Cream Machine.
Yes, sir. Hey, there you go. Colorable tie-up.
Does that mean we're getting ice cream?
I hope so. I love ice cream.
Who doesn't love ice cream? That's the one thing we're going to agree on tonight.
We're going to agree on that, is the ice cream. Sam Osborne here. From down under, referee Harry D, senior official. What a great referee.
That's your opinion. But I tell you what, Ice Cream Machine here now, great side of it.
Yeah.
Sam Osborne really put together, but so I think Ice Cream Machine has been kind of controlling the action.
I see that. Hey, what an amazing turnout. Here, all the fans coming to support independent wrestling in Ontario.
Yeah, great crowd here, as there, you know, seems to almost always be when Battle Arts is here and when Destiny World Wrestling is here. Great crowds here at the Don Pulloff Arena, night after night after night, and it's because there's great wrestling going out there, giving fans value for their money.
That's right. Here we go. Look at this. Beautiful Ice Cream Machine, still in control.
Now, do you think he's soft serve or hard ice cream?
I hope soft serve.
Osborne there, I think, maybe had a hold of the mask there of Ice Cream Machine.
Did he? Oh! Right in the abdominal area. Look at this. The buckle up and over. Ice Cream Machine right now. Look at this. I thought that was some kind of a cross-faced chicken wing type of thing he was doing.
Yeah, absolutely. He was trying to get it there. But I'll tell you what, Sam Osborne here is no slouch. Like you said, he's from down under. He's got the cool accent. And he seems to know what he's doing in the ring, too.
He's in great physical shape, showing it off right now as he's in full control. Fans are screaming ice cream.
Ice cream, you scream, we all scream.
Scream ice cream. I never heard that before.
Really? I think it's segments. Now, I got to say, this Sam Osborne really put together not just physically, but also his wrestling techniques. Very solid. You notice he seems to put that extra little oomph into everything he does there, Ice. He knows how to kind of string together the moves out. Not like Ice Cream Machine now, resorting to close.
Look at this.
Bones.
Wow. Into the buckle.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Ice Cream Machine here certainly seems to be in trouble.
Absolutely. Oh, my. Look at this. Big body slam center of the ring. Hey, look who it is. It's Anthony Corelli. Come on over here, Anthony.
Now, you don't. AC. You do not bring Anthony Corelli over
now,
here.
You and him, you guys don't see eye to eye a lot of the times.
Look, I've got a temporary injunction, a restraining.
Come on, you did not do that.
The things that he's done to me, he is not allowed to be within 25 feet of me. And if he walks past here again, I'm going to have him arrested and escorted out of his own building.
Would you stop? Are you telling me you went to the lengths of hiring a lawyer and getting some kind of an injunction on Anthony Corelli?
I'm not wearing this suit to sit next to you. I'm wearing this suit because I was in the Superior Court of Ontario this morning making sure that that restraining order was taken out against Anthony Corelli because he's a menace to society.
Would you stop? He is not a menace to society. He's a great guy. He's a great pillar of the community. He does so much for the students here. I mean, even the scholarships. He's such a great individual. How dare you say such nonsense?
I'm sure the scholarship is a con for him to pocket a little extra money.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize for the comments made by one Scott DeMore. Sometimes he... another thing I could say. He's just going to come back and say something crazy.
I'll say something better than whatever you're saying.
Just stop. Let's listen to the fans. Let's get to the end. They're screaming ice cream.
And are they screaming for the protein ice cream and concessions or for the rest?
It's a good question. By the way, the ice cream and concessions is fantastic.
Almost as fantastic as Sam Osborne's looked here. He's really thrown everything he's got at Ice Cream Machine, and somehow Ice Cream Machine's still finding that way to slip that shoulder up right before the three count. There's been three or four really good opportunities that Osborne's had to win this matchup. But Ice Cream Machine's been able to get out every time.
Look at this. Here he goes. Whoa! Chop from Ice Cream Machine. Another one. There it is. These fans are losing it. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, with a big elbow. I think it's over here. Hook the leg. One, two. Oh, and how did Osborne kick out of that?
You know, despite the fact that I watched Ice Cream Machine load something, some type of foreign object into that elbow protector, Osborne still found a way.
Wait a minute, say that again. What did you just say? Are you accusing Ice Cream Machine of doing some kind of illegal activity?
Absolutely, he's a cheat.
He is not. Look at this. Oh, into the buckle. There he is. Ice Cream Machine. Wait a minute. Grabs the leg. Turns it over. There it is. The cross face. He's got him. He's going to try to make him tap. It could be all over. There it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner by way of submission, the Ice Cream Machine!
You know, Ice, it all started when the Ice Cream Machine illegally loaded up that elbow protector and hit Sam Osborne. That's how he was able to gain the advantage. Harry D missed it, so we've had another travesty of justice.
Would you stop? That is complete nonsense. Absolutely not. He won it fair and square.
Oh, stop it. That's exactly what happened. The reason everybody screams for Ice Cream is because he's a cheater and they're trying to point it out, and you're supporting him, and that makes me sick.
Unbelievable. Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it for our first matchup. Stick around. Lots more action still to come. We'll be right back.
Pasquale Di Papa and the Di Papa family all coming down here to ringside. What a wonderful treat we have here. The best part about this, the Iceman, I don't know, he ran away somewhere. Oh, Mr. Di Papa, such a pleasure to see you. He's scared of you and he ran away. Such an honor to have a man like Pasquale Di Papa coming out here. He's got all of his charges with him. This is a true force in wrestling. And oh yeah, now that Pasquale Di Papa's gone, cowardly Iceman here has come back to the table. Pasquale Di Papa said it, said you were running, you wouldn't be here when he was, and you did exactly what he said you would.
You know, I can't stand to look at him. I'm not going to lie.
Be quiet. Be quiet. Show a little respect for these champions.
If you guys don't shut your mouth, I will slap the taste each and every one of your mouths. Shut up.
Shut your mouth. Disrespectful people. My name is Pasquale Di Papa, and I am the landlord of this beautiful building.
You suck.
I didn't hear that.
Shut up, because you will all be property of Di Papa. You will all be property of Di Papa. I guarantee it. Hey, who's got the biggest mouth? Listen, Di Papa's family is full of champions. I have Randy Ray, 6'6", 260 pounds. I have the ultimate Dustin Quicksilver, who's a technical...
The disrespect is sickening here, Iceman. Utterly sickening, the lack of respect for the Di Papa fan.
I'm telling you, I don't know what they're saying.
You're gonna care! Give me that!
I don't know what's going on here. You didn't hear me say we don't care.
I absolutely heard.
You did not.
If you don't shut your mouth and show some respect to these champions, we will not! We will not! We will stay in this ring all night! Now,
shh, shh,
quiet, quiet, Ava. Be quiet! To show people that you will be property of Di Papa. Give me that. I'm gonna buy you fans for a hot dog and a Coke. What you gonna take? What do you want? Put that on. He will be property of Di Papa, just like all of you will be property of Di Papa.
I am disgusted. He just threw a shirt, ladies and gentlemen. Pasquale Di Papa just threw a shirt at a fan. He's telling him to put it on. Wait a minute, the music just hit. The music just hit right now.
Who's this guy?
Wait a minute. There he is, Ray Bernardo. He's here, ladies and gentlemen. Wow. There he is, Mike DeRossi.
Hey, hey.
And Kingdom Come.
What are these guys doing out here during time that was set aside for Papa?
Back up! Back up! Back up! If you touch them, I will shut this down and I will send these rednecks home with nothing to do so.
Wow.
Back up!
This is all hell's about to break
back
loose.
Back up!
You know what? You know what? Whoa. Guys, relax.
Wow, the guy in the front row who got the Pasquale Di shirt, he put it on. I guess that makes him property of Pasquale Di Papa.
I am sick and tired of hearing your mouth, and so are all these people.
Yeah, me too. I'm pretty sick and tired of listening to him.
Just suck up to these losers, Ray.
Listen, it's enough I got to listen to you. I don't want to listen to Pasquale Di Papa.
Now, I will tell you, yes, you got some great specimens. Randy Ray. Not all. Let's give credit where credit is due. You got Randy Rain, an undefeated heavyweight champion.
Say it again. I want to hear.
Randy Rain, the undefeated heavyweight champion. And you also have Dustin Quicksilver. I think went 195 days as champion. Also undefeated. Now, the funny thing is, you can't be undefeated if you don't defend your titles.
Technically, you can be, though, Ice.
Now, we also have the self-proclaimed greatest athlete in the building.
Technicalities. Details.
By the way, that's a nice suit, the Papa. I like that. What time you gotta return it?
Whoa! Okay. Did you hear that?
Now, you claim to have the best roster in wrestling? No. I've got Randy Bino.
Stop clapping,
yep.
Iceman.
Yeah, I'm. Okay, Randy. You know it. And I got his tag team partner. Together they make Kingdom Come, DJ. And I have the one, the only, the mercenary, Mike DeRosti.
What a great guy.
You know what? Actually, really? Yeah. You took Mike out. You took Mike out with a set of brass knuckles supplied by your manager, the Papa. Okay? So I guess you guys should put your money where your mouth is. If you guys, are you guys ready for a match? You guys are ready for a match, guaranteed. Are you guys, no, clearly you guys, are you guys ready for a match tonight? Well, sir, how are you?
Wow, look at this. You Anthony Corelli just walked in the ring.
As much as I'm enjoying, let's turn up the mic a little bit, please. As much as I'm enjoying the banter back and forth, both guys actually have a very good point. You have an awesome roster. You have an awesome roster. So, since it is Survivor Series weekend.
Oh, wait a minute.
How about we have a 3-on-3 Survivor Series main event tonight?
Wow, what a blockbuster announcement from the commissioner.
Yes, I can do that. I recommend you guys go back to the locker room and warm up. You guys get back. You guys got some action.
Now, that's exactly what you'd expect out of Anthony Corelli, coming out here, railroading the entire segment, taking over the show, doing whatever he thinks he wants to do, having no idea about fairness, having no idea about what's proper.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight the main event will be a Survivor Series-style elimination match between Dustin Quicksilver, Randy Rain, and JP Morgado against the team of DJ Randy Bino and Mercenary Mike DeRosti!
It's sickening. It's totally sickening, and I can't believe it. It's disgusting.
That's a really nice shirt, by the way. What a great shirt. I gotta tell you, Randy Rain walking. We have JP Morgado just walked by the commentary position with Dustin Quicksilver. Here he comes. De Papa with the world champion. That was disgusting. Disgusting.
Hey, at least we agree on something. It was disgusting the way Anthony Corelli came out here and totally took advantage of the kindness of Pasquale Di Papa. He was willing to share his ring with that loser Bernardo. And still, Corelli comes up there and practically spits in Di Papa's face.
He did not.
Disgusting.
He did not.
It'd have been better if he spit
in his face. Mike DeRosi, Randy Bino, of course, DJ, and the one and only, they're managed by this man. What a great guy, pillar to the community. I'm talking about Ray Bernardo. What a great guy.
He don't even tuck his dress shirt into his pathetic $9
jeans. All right, ladies and gentlemen, does that sound like a main event to you? Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is part of the Battle Arts Academy Women's Division. Here we go, some great women's division action. These two,
introducing first, from the Fiji Isles, Aria Wild Sapphire.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a turn of events here. They came out to cut a promo, and then they were interrupted by Kingdom Come, Mercenary Mike, and now the main event on the show is a Survivor Series main event, elimination, man. Huge main event.
And now we have the ladies' action here, Sapphire in the ring.
Wild Sapphire.
And her opponent, from Toronto, Ontario, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jesse Mack.
There it is, ladies and gentlemen, a new upcomer, Jesse Mack.
So if Sapphire is wild, what is Jesse Mack here, Ice? little, perky, spunky.
Yeah.
Spunky.
She's spunky.
And the referee? Confused. Maybe confused.
You have anything nice to say to Moore?
I have lots of nice things to say about myself and the Pasquale Di Papa family.
How can you associate yourself with that Di Papa?
What do you mean, how can I associate? He's a class act. He's a good man. One, he's the landlord here. Didn't you hear?
Yes.
You never win a fight with your landlord.
I mean, he's just so rude and mean to all the fans, and he's kind of a creep.
Why would he ever be nice to the fans?
You gotta be nice to the fans.
They need him. He doesn't need them. All right, action here underway. Sapphire and Jesse Mack. Collar elbow tie up here, and Sapphire with a full arm and twist. Great to see ladies' action here on display as part of the Ontario Super Series, showing that it's not just the best of the three great companies, but it's the best of both genders, male and female, on display here as part of the Super Series.
The Super Series. It's a new type of event going on here in Ontario. You know, the brainchild of one Anthony Corelli, where he brings the three top promotions together to do, you know, a great showcase, and people are loving it. The stands are full. It's a full house. It's a Friday night, and man, are they getting their money's worth.
Well, it's successful because I'm here, Ice. It's not because you're here. It's not because Corelli's here.
Wow.
It's because I'm here. It's because Border City Wrestling's here. I'll give credit where credit is due. Battle Arts, Destiny, two great companies. Border City Wrestling, 25 years strong, buddy.
25 years. It's a long time, man.
It is a long time.
Here he goes. Look at this. One. Wow. Now, there's no animosity really between these two. You know what I mean? I mean, they're kind of like just putting on a good match.
Well, I mean, so far in this matchup, you've seen technical wrestling. But I think what you're going to see as this match goes on, you always start to see it. As the match progresses, you start to see some frustration. And that's what leads to the real
fight. Let's see. Let's see who will break here. Yeah, there we go. Collar will tie up. Sapphire, wait a minute. Sending Jesse into the ropes. There we go. Off the rope. Whoa, misses with a clothesline. Oh, hold on a sec. With a front face lock here. Trying to make her tap or bring her to her knees.
Referee there should check. I think Mac may be using an illegal choke.
Would you stop it? There's no illegal chokes there.
Why are you telling me to stop it? I'm just providing color analysis.
You're lying. That's what you're telling. You're trying to make the fans at home believe that she's doing something illegal. Oh! Did you see that?
Well, you'd slap somebody if they were illegally choking you, too.
There's no winning, ladies and gentlemen.
Wonder what it would take to get one of these girls to come down here and slap you like that.
Would you stop? Look at this. Beautiful. Ooh, with a kick to the back. Oh, well done from Jesse Mack.
I noticed that you don't point out that Jesse Mack was kicking Sapphire from behind in a very cowardly action.
I didn't see that.
How did you not see it? It was right in front of us.
My monitor was off.
Your brain is off.
Would you stop? Look at this. Wait a minute. Oh, look at that. Come on. She used the ropes as a weapon there.
I didn't see it. My monitor is off you, J-Bro.
You stop it.
Sapphire there almost getting an early victory here.
Look at that. She's got her hands in her hair. Come on, referee. Get in there. That's hands on the hair. This referee, is he a BCW referee?
He is absolutely not a BCW referee, or he'd have short hair and no goatee.
Well, he's definitely not a...
Sapphire using full advantage of the 5-second rule, using the full 4 seconds to do her damage.
Uh-huh, look at this. Picks her up. Oh, my! Ooh! Side suplex. Knocked her right out. She kicked me out. One! Oh! She kicked out.
A little FYI for you there, Ice. That's a side salto, as in Masa Saito. He's a big Japanese star. Maybe you heard of him. I don't know. Might have thrown a boulder through a Burger King with Ken Patera once.
Is that a true story?
Oh, yeah.
Was it really?
A short little time, Saito and Patera had a little fun in the joint.
Wow. Man, I know those Ken Patera stories.
# knowledge laid.
Wow. Here we go. Sapphire in full control. Jessie now not doing too well. She's got to dig deep. She's really got to want it. This could be over for her. Oh, she was holding her mouth, holding her jaw. Could have been dislocated.
I wish we could dislocate your jaw. But I'll tell you what, nice. Sapphire here doing a great job of wearing down Mackie. Now she just seems to be balking her. Sapphire might be taking a little bit too much time.
Here we go. I think it's over for Jessie Mack, ladies and gentlemen. It's over. Here we go. She's gonna take it home. Look at this. Whoa, with a bridge. Oh, wow. That's extremely painful.
Putting pressure on not just the neck, not just the back, but the legs as well, but somehow...
Wait a minute, look at this! Jessie Mack is doing it now! Oh.
And despite Mack going back to that illegal chokehold, Sapphire's still able to gallantly fight out from underneath.
Well, you know, to her credit, Sapphire definitely has more experience than Jessie. Jessie's a newbie here, and Sapphire, you know, was in England just recently, was also in Japan. So she's been traveling the world, and she's definitely the more veteran. Oh, the double clothesline! But Sapphire, definitely the veteran out of these two.
Well, this is Mack's opportunity. If she's going to mount a comeback, it's certainly going to come from here. She's taken a lot of abuse. Sapphire
standing four
for the majority of the matchup here. Referee counting five, six. Looks like both getting to their feet here. Mack with a couple of big arm drags and a clothesline. Perched on the second rope.
Here we go. Oh, she caught her! She caught her, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, it looks like Max got that illegal chokehold back on there. She's cutting off.
What are you
the
talking about illegal? It is not. That is a submission. I could have sworn I saw her tap.
Oh, looks like.
Look at this.
The hold.
Oh my God. Oh, what a big two. It's over.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Aria Wild Sapphire!
Shades of the late Dr. Death, Steve Williams, not just with the power slam, but smashing her into the corner turnbuckle pad, then whipping her around. Big, powerful Oklahoma-style slam there. Sapphire, deservedly your winner. I know you don't like it here, Ice, but it's about time that a deserving person wins a matchup.
And with that, we'll leave it. Sapphire victorious in this ladies' division here at Battle Arts Academy. Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with some more action.
Our next match, which is scheduled for one fall, is a tag team match. Introducing first, from Shanghai, weighing in at 187 pounds, Solo Forbes! And his tag team partner from Nassau in the Bahamas, weighing in at 234 pounds, T.O.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Battle Arts Academy, alongside BCW, Border City Wrestling, and Destiny World Wrestling, three top promotions combined their forces for something new called the Ontario Series.
From Stirling, Scotland, weighing in at 394 pounds, the tag team of Freedom Wallace and Bradford Montague, Clan Freedom!
Ladies and gentlemen, a special tag team contest here. T.O. teaming up with Bolo Fung as they take on Montague and Freedom Wallace. Clan Freedom from Scotland. There they are, the Scottish have arrived.
You know, thanks, Ice, because I don't think the people could have figured out that Clan Freedom in their kilts was from Scotland.
Oh, Lord, help us.
Might have thought they were from San Francisco or something.
It could be.
Oh, you'd know them by a first-name basis if they were.
Where are you from, Scotty?
I'm from Windsor, Ontario, Canada. It's right near Columbus, Ohio.
You know what comes from Columbus, Ohio?
Frankie Williams.
That's right. You know what else comes out of Windsor?
All things good.
Stop it. Maybe you ought to be making pizzas or something like that. You know, pizzas?
You ever had a Windsor-style pie, you'd never want to eat one of these rotten Toronto pizzas.
Would you stop it? Let's get to the action. Ladies and gentlemen, here it is. Tag team action. Battle Arts talent representing. Wow, they just threw the kilts into referee. Nick Wadley here is our referee for this one.
Clan Freedom here, I've got to say, have got to be the favorites in this matchup here. I think they've got a little bit more under their belt as a tag team. They also, I think, have a size advantage. But you know what? We'll see what T.O. and Fung can do.
Yes. The fans are not too keen on Clan Freedom. He's getting a massage. Would you be serious? Scott Montague giving him a massage? It's disgusting. Here's the bell.
So we've got Fung and Wallace here starting it off.
Now the fans are not screaming freedom, they're screaming free dumb. Dumb as in dumb. You're an idiot.
Now that's insulting. Why would you
I never
say
said that?
That
myself. I'm just repeating what the fans are referring to.
You just said that.
Oh, I'm not saying it coming from me. I'm repeating what the fans are saying. I just want the viewers at home to know what's going on.
You know, you have a crappy attitude because you're from T.O. You get what I'm saying?
Wow.
Ah, you're from T.O.?
Wow. That's terrible. Just got that. Here they go. Bobo Fung, a martial artist. Oh, look at this. Beautiful reversal here.
Obviously, Fung and Wallace, having known each other over the time here at Battle Arts, they've competed multiple times, and you can see that they kind of know each other's
maneuvers. Yes.
They're kind of anticipating what the other's going to do. See, that's one of the things. When you wrestle someone multiple times, you start to know the person, their moves, their counters, and that's where you really start seeing the chess game that is professional wrestling.
Here he goes. T.O.'s in the ring. Great guy. Fans love him. He's come a long way, such a long way. He picks up on this so well. What a great guy, man. I got to say, I got to meet him and hang out with him backstage. Super good guy.
He's from what? Woodstock?
He is. Long way. Big fan favorite here. Here he goes. Puts him off the ropes. Oh, big shoulder block.
T.O. able to use the size advantage, but now...
Oh, wow.
Let's see what he's going to do as Freedom tags in Montague, and now T.O. doesn't really have that advantage.
Wait a minute, he's putting in a mouthpiece. Now, for those who don't know, Montague was, look at this, was actually in Scotland, while Freedom Wallace was here in Toronto, and then... You know, a few shows back, Freedom made the call, and he threw him in, got him his papers, and said, hey, we're going to be tag team partners here, watching over the family. Oh, what a beautiful arm drag. Wow, Freedom and Montague are not doing too well right now.
Yeah, it pains me to say that Fung and T.O. so far controlling the early action, but it's early.
Why does it pain you for?
Because they're really not nice people.
Would you stop? Here he goes, front face lock here from Bolo Fung. Bolo Fung, you know, he's into taekwondo, judo, MMA. He's got all those attributes, looking great.
Yeah, but I know taekwondo, I know judo, I know jiu-jitsu,
no, you see,
I know karate, and I know six other Japanese words, too.
You know, wow, you may know them, but you don't, you're not a student of them. He's an actual student.
Yeah, I'm a graduate. It's way better.
Stop it. So I'm just going to say, with that in his arsenal, that could give him the upper hand. It could give him the advantage.
Well, and right now, Clan Freedom having the advantage here now, and Freedom tagging in Montague, the big man now. Going to see
he
use that size and strength advantage just here and wear down.
Brute force. Complete brute force. Oh, look at that. Punishing him. Running his knee into the mat.
You know, Fung has had some health issues lately, George. I mean, he's had some issues. He was under concussion protocol there for a little bit. He's had some issues with his leg previously.
Uh-huh.
So it's going to see how he's able to withstand this punishment.
Yeah, that's not good, I have to say. There's T.O. trying to get Bolo. Trying to get the fans behind him. But he's holding on to his knee. He may have tore a ligament or hyperextended the knee, and that would not be good.
Well, thank you, Dr. Ice, but as Freedom here continues to work over that leg, Smart Tag Team Wrestling, Montague and Freedom tagging in out. They've isolated that left leg of Fums and really starting to wear him down. And you notice, if you were to cut a line right down the center of the ring, where is Fung? He's on Clan Freedom's side.
Yes,
of the ring.
They definitely did well cutting the ring in half. Doing a great job here thus far.
Yeah, leaving that stupid T.O. over on the other side of the ring where he can't
just
do nothing.
Stop. Do you have anything good to say?
I think that Freedom Wallace and Monsky are doing amazing. I just finished saying that. Obviously, you're not listening, Ice.
Oh, man.
It's no wonder you're single.
Would you stop it? How do you know I'm single?
Because you pathetically hit on every girl that's around.
Would you? No, that's not true. You know, unlike you, I don't have a problem getting a date on a Saturday night.
Sometimes you don't even have to pay for them.
Wow. No winning with this guy. Here we go, back to the action. Montague in full control. Oh, and he just dropped him on his knee, doing more damage. I am telling you, this is a dangerous situation for Bolo Fong. He needs to get to that corner. He needs to make that tag. And for those watching, you know, we do have physicians backstage, thank goodness, that are on watch in case, you know, they got to take him to the hospital.
Yeah, and at some point in time here, right, somebody's going to have to make a call whether Fong can continue from a health
From the top rope. Freedom Wallace dropping a knee, blunt force, onto the already injured knee of Bolo Fong.
You know, if I was T.O., which thankfully I'm not, and tag team partners with Fong, I would start considering throwing in the towel so Fong doesn't get hurt any worse.
No, I don't tend to agree with you, but... Oh, look at that. Come on, that was a cheap shot. That was disgusting. Well, who does that?
T.O. said something mean about Freedom Wallace.
He didn't say anything.
He did too.
Come on, referee. Turn around. There's a double team going on here. Turn around, referee. Disgusting display of sportsmanship from the Clan. Looks like something you enjoyed.
Well, T.O. not doing anything smart. He's got the referee turned around, giving the opportunity for Clan Freedom to be two-on-one against Funk. So really, it's T.O.'s fault.
Unbelievable. But... to the credit of the Clan, they are cutting the ring in half. They're in full control. They're continuously working on that knee because they know that's his weakness. And they're going to go for the kill like a tiger on a gazelle.
Yeah, this has been 3-4 minutes here, Ice, of Clan Freedom working over Fung's leg repeatedly. They've cut the ring in half. They've isolated him. Yep. They've worked on that leg. And Fung can't have much more left in the tank.
Absolutely. He's digging deep, but... it doesn't look good. The fans are getting behind him. They're cheering. They're cleaning. Look at that. Oh, come on. Turn around. There's the tag. The tag is me. A legal tag. What? Come on, referee.
Wow, the referee's got to get T.O. out of the ring there. T.O. coming running into the ring. And Clan Freedom now back with Fung isolated in their corner. That's good tag team wrestling.
Man, I am disgusted with this. This referee... He doesn't have his eye open. Wait a minute, he's going for a submission right now. Freedom Wallace in full control. He's going to try to make him tag. Hyperextend his lower back. Look at this.
I think
Fung. He's really fighting it.
I think Wallace may be making a mistake here. After all that isolation on the leg now, he goes to a move that works over the back.
Look at this.
And it works against him.
Yes, it did. You caught that. He didn't go to the leg. You're right. He went to the lower back, and that may have been his mistake. There's the tag, and the tag is made. Here comes T.O. Big close line. Big wave. There it is. Look at this. Oh, into the corner. Belly to belly in the center of the ring. Hooks the leg. One. Interfering in the match.
Very smartly, Wallace sitting here coming in and saving his team.
Oh, look at this. It's a pure six brawl. There's no control going on. All the men are in the ring.
Referee maybe losing control of this action here. We got Montague and T.O. in the ring.
Misses. Look at this. Montague picks him up. Wait a minute. Freedom Wallace from behind, like the creep that he is. Picks him up. Look at this double team effort. Come on, count him, referee. That's a five count. Big elbow.
And this is going to be a three count. Two, three.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners. Clan Freedom.
I am disgusted.
Now, I got to say, Ice, it was very, very unfair, the situation that T.O.
was put in. You're right.
His partner's a coward, stayed on the floor instead of coming in to help him, and T.O. was left there to fend for himself, and nobody's going to be able to succeed when they're in there with Clan Freedom 2-on-1. I think Fung was really a coward on this.
That's disgusting. He's outside the ring with a damaged knee. The referee's over in backstage. His physicians, you know, they're standing backstage. They're waiting. Man, physician standing by to help him.
How about a round of applause for Bolo and Tio, everybody?
I'm sure Bolo Fung and Tio will be back. Bigger and better than ever. And so will we, ladies and gentlemen. Stick around. More action still to come.
Introducing first, from Newcastle, England, weighing in at 18 stone, the British Brawler!
Kenny D just thinks he's the shit. How you doing? British Brawler making his way to the ring here, and boy, seeing a lot of thumbs down out there, right? British Brawler, thick kid, got that old school look to him. Let's see if he's got that World of Sport talent.
There he is, ladies and gentlemen, the British Brawler.
Brawler looking a little thicker than last I saw him and spending some time in the gym.
Bare knuckles fighter.
And his opponent, from Hamilton, Ontario, weighing in at 215 pounds, the Wrecking Ball, James Runyon!
Wow, the Wrecking Ball, James Runyon coming out. I believe originally from Calgary, Alberta.
Canada.
Correct.
You can't say the first two without the third. Haven't you watched wrestling?
We are in Ontario, so I'm saying Calgary, Alberta, and
Canada.
You don't have to say it.
If we can be serious for a moment.
Oh, stop. Looking in great shape. James Runyon doing a great job against the British Brawler. Brawler back from a world tour. He was in Tokyo, Japan. He was in Newcastle, England, Ireland, just traveling the world. This is going to be a great matchup, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, I'll tell you what, Runyon, you got his hands full in there with British Brawler. Like you said, coming off of a world tour, thick put together lad. And let's see if he can hang with the Brawler.
Let's see. Here they go. Look at this. A little bit of grappling here. Olympic-style wrestling.
Brawler with the double underhook there, which, as anybody who's done any amateur wrestling know, means total control.
Complete. Referee Harry D, what an amazing official.
Oh, stop it. That Freddie Mercury look-alike.
Just stop.
He's in Corelli and Yuri's pocket, and it makes me sick.
No, he is not. You just hate him because he can't be bought. I've heard rumors that you've tried to put envelopes in his pocket and you denied him. That's the word.
You know me. I wouldn't put an envelope in anyone's pocket.
That's, you know what? You definitely would. Anything to get it your way.
Runyon there, I think, holding on to the tights there, backing Brawler into the ropes. So a little bit of cheating there, and obviously referee Harry D lets him get away with it.
Here we go. Look at this. James Runyon here. Collarable tie. Oh, look at this. Big headlock. Oh, look at this. It's that amateur wrestling style. Very tough. Oh, look at this. Oh, wow. These guys are going at it here. This is just not very technical. This is more brawling. Oh! Oh, look at this! Jeez, the power! The strength of the British Brawler! Oh, and he missed!
You know, Brawler's got those taped fists. If he connects with one of those, it could be an early knockout. Ooh, big judo arm throw there by Runyon, and he seems to have control of Brawler at this moment. Now cinching in that arm bar, seeming to focus on the left arm there, Brawlers. Top wrist lock there by Runyon.
Very nice. Great work. This is some great amateur wrestling here.
Now got it into a key lock.
A little bit of that strong style that you would see in Japan. Of course, they are currently being trained by Mr. Ishikawa. Oh! Dropkick.
Ishikawa-san, a true legend,
yes,
both in the MMA world and in the professional wrestling world. That's one of the few things we're going to agree on here.
Well, you know what's best for you if you don't want him to come to this table and choke you out.
I get along fine with him, but he does not have nice things to say about you.
Would you stop? He doesn't speak English.
I speak Japanese, and he says you shopai.
Wait a minute. Ladies and gentlemen, I think he popped his shoulder out. James Runyon got slammed by a British brawler, and I think he popped his shoulder. He popped his shoulder out.
I'll pop it back in.
Anthony Corelli's there. Wow, ladies and gentlemen. This is horrible. Hey! Come on!
That was fantastic. Why, oh, why would Brawler stop just because Runyon has a little bobo on his shoulder? Brawler working over that injured shoulder of Runyon's. This is great. You know, they've got the Iceman speechless, which is something I've been praying for years. Brawler just working over that injured shoulder of Runyon. And, you know, Anthony Corelli came out here. If he was really so concerned, he should have stopped the match. But he doesn't care because he's scared you have to refund somebody's money or something.
Wow. It's disgusting, ladies and gentlemen. I am absolutely appalled with what transpired. Unbelievable. He was injured. He didn't give him a moment to breathe. The guy, they're trying to pop his shoulder back. And he attacked him. He attacked him. That's a scumbag move.
Why wouldn't you attack him? The match was still ongoing. Harry D, Anthony Corelli both had an opportunity to cancel this match. They could have called the match. They could have called it a no contest. They could have had Runyon forfeit, and they did it.
Here it is, ladies and gentlemen. After that injured shoulder, it could be over right here.
Brawler going for the Fujiwara-style arm drag there. Oh, and using the face grind there. He's got to break that hand grip that Runyon has. If he can do that and pull on that arm and straighten it out. But Runyon really fighting it hard.
Man, the British brawler, as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, is ruthless. Absolutely ruthless.
Brawler doing a great job of working over that shoulder of Runyon's.
Wow.
You know, Ison, you're so worried about Runyon. Why don't you go have Harry D call the contest? Declare the brawler the winner right now.
Man. Look at that, just absolutely ruthless, this guy.
Ruthless wins matches.
He is a British bully, that's the fans.
Well, as Donald Trump has taught us all, it pays to be a bully.
Are you talking about Donald Trump ain't a bully?
I don't think so either, but that's what people call him. Just like they call the British brawler a bully, but he's not. He's like Trump, he's a winner, and he's gonna make battle arts wrestling great again.
Wow. Never a loss for words once got the war. Just give him a mic.
I really don't need a mic, I can yell pretty loud.
Jeez. Here he goes, he's in full control. Ladies and gentlemen, you know what? The fans are trying to get behind him. I'm gonna go out and say, I was behind this poor kid. I thought he had a really good chance, and I thought he was gonna do well, James Runyon, but unfortunately, that shoulder injury, it's just not good. Brawler's all over him. Look at this, it's just bad. I think it's over.
But boy, I feel like CNN totally exposing your bias. Unfortunately, he's not doing well. How about talking about the fact that the British brawler has been completely dominant in this matchup? Say it, Ice. Completely dominant.
The fact that you
this win would be CNN. huge, I say.
It is absolutely unbelievable. I am nothing like CNN, by the way. I actually told the truth. It looks like it's over.
The slowest count ever being administered here by Harry D.
Well, he's counting illegitimately.
Illegitimately? Yes, absolutely.
Legitimately. Whoa, he made it in! He made it!
Well, credit where credit is due, showing a lot of moxie here. Runyon getting back in the ring, but maybe not a lot of brains here because he's going to back in there and he's going to absorb a lot more punishment from Brawler.
Yes. I do feel sorry for James Runyon. He's a great competitor.
You feel sorry for him. He could give up at any moment, but he's too stupid to do so.
No, he's not. He's trying to be an athlete. He's trying to muster and go through the pain. But, did you see that? Unbelievable! Hit me and knocked him out with a knee! Ring the bell! I think he knocked him out with a knee!
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner is the result of a referee stoppage, the Wrecking Ball, James Runyon!
Wow, what a turn of events! Look at that, your man, with everything he put through to James Runyon. James Runyon dug in deep, and with that big knee, he knocked the wind right out of the Brawler, and that's what you get.
You know, there's at least 15 times that referee Harry D could have called this contest and awarded it to Brawler. He did it. Brawler absorbs one kick. He's on the ground for less than 3 seconds. And Harry D calls for the bell. Hey. It's sickening. It's disgusting. The fix is in. The Electoral College did it. You're making me sick, guys. Call it honestly. Look, Brawler's on his feet, and he's pissed, and he has every right to be.
He got knocked out. The referee actually did him a service by stopping the match because he couldn't, if the oxygen didn't get to his head because he was attacked, he could have gone into a coma. So congratulations to the referee for keeping these fighters safe, and a great win for James Runyon.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest is a tag team match, and it is our special Border City Wrestling Showcase match. All of the superstars involved in this match are the superstars of Border City Wrestling. Introducing first, from Gainesville, Florida, weighing in at 215 pounds, the genetic jackpot, Joe Coleman, and his tag team partner from Dearborn, Michigan, weighing in at 205 pounds, Idris Abraham.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to it. It is the Ontario Super Show, a great new series. Border City Wrestling, Battle Arts and Destiny combined right now. A special matchup on this amazing night. Some of the top talent from Border City Wrestling are being showcased right here in front of this capacity crowd. Abraham and Joe Coleman. And get ready, their tag team
and
opponents.
Their opponents.
Introducing first, from Toronto, Ontario, weighing in at 195 pounds, Brett Money Bang! One of the biggest cruiserweights
and his tag
in
team
Canada.
Partner.
From London, Ontario, weighing in at 202 pounds, recently featured in the Cruiserweight Classic, ladies and gentlemen, Tyson Dude! There he is, ladies and gentlemen, already a legend in the business. He has accomplished so much. Former champion for Border City Wrestling. He is here tonight, the top talent in Ontario. Signed talent, the Border City Wrestling being showcased today. Fasten your seatbelts, call your friends, get ready. This is going to be unbelievable.
Absolutely, Ice. The stars of Border City Wrestling taking center stage here at the Ontario Super Series. If Destiny was involved, it would just be a series, but when you add Border City Wrestling, it definitely becomes super. Look at four amazing athletes in the ring. I've had my problems with Tyson Dukes. I'm not a huge fan personally of Brent Banks, but there's no question they're two amazing athletes, and they're staring across at two other amazing athletes in the genetic jackpot, Joe Coleman and Idris Abraham.
Idris Abraham.
Are you mocking me?
No, not. I'm just repeating.
I'm trying to be respectful of his culture, and you're being mocking, and it's sickening, Ice.
Not at all. Not at all. I'm calling it like it is. You're a gentleman in a class act.
Practically a hate crime.
Would you stop it? This is going to be unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Get ready. Fasten your seatbelts. The crowd is screaming, too much protein.
You know, it's been proven scientifically that that's a fallacy about protein. Your body still stores it and uses it up over a period of time, and these fans showing their ignorance by not keeping up on the medical studies.
Wow. Well, thank God you're here to tell us.
There's one thing I know, it's nutrition. I might not follow it, but I know it.
Look at this. What are these guys doing?
They're psyching themselves up, Ice.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Joe Coleman. Gonna cart things off. Tyson Dukes.
You know, Joe Coleman, originally a trainee of somebody that you know very well, Ice, Rip Rogers. Then he realized that good as Rip was, he needed real help.
Wow.
So he came and trained with myself, and that's where he met young Idris. And these two, I think, could form a potentially tremendous team.
First and foremost, Rip Rogers is one of the greatest instructors on the planet.
Well, that's because he learned back with me and him in a tag team. I like taught him a bunch.
Stop. He's had over 65 people signed to the big leagues. He currently travels the world and trying to help these kids. He is an unbelievable instructor, and any talent in the world who has an opportunity should take his course.
Right after they take mine.
Wow. Now we'll give you credit.
10 world champions.
I will give you credit. You've got some very big names currently signed to the WWE, ROH, TNA. I will say
New Japan. WrestleOne.
Basically the biggest promotions in the world have your talent. So I'll give you kudos to that.
And we got some great talent. Four of them in here, right here. Three of them Can-Am grads. All four of them representing Border City Wrestling. And Tyson Dukes, can't stand the man personally, but what a talent!
Unbelievable superstar. Look at that, Tyson Dukes. The cyborg, the template of professional wrestling here in Canada.
No, you talk about a hybrid. Tyson Dukes, he knows that catch-as-catch-can style
of
wrestling. He's also trained in martial arts. He's got that Muay Thai background. When I first met him, he was the Muay Thai kid.
Really?
That's going back many, many years. Look at those knees, the way he uses the point, drives it into the elbow and the forearm, really wearing down that arm. Now reaching over, pulling the other arm.
Oh, wow.
Putting pressure on both shoulders, both arms. This,
look at this.
I hate to say it, is wrestling expertise.
Well, I will say that it looks like Tyson Dukes is currently putting on a clinic on how it's done. Look at this. He's just absolutely demolishing Joe Coleman. He's dissecting him. Worked the arm, he worked the fingers, he worked the wrist, he worked the elbow. Unbelievable. What a talent.
Now notice there, Tyson Dukes made the tag to Banks, and Coleman used that split second opportunity where Tyson had to let go with one hand to make the tag and get the freshman Idris in.
Oh, look at this. Brett Banks got him by the foot now. Well, he missed with a clothesline. Off the ropes. Oh, again, off the ropes. Again. Oh, the big shoulder block.
Reminiscent of Speed Muscle in Japan there. Look at how shredded Abraham is.
He is in fantastic
Abraham put
condition.
Together. He's been training with Joe Coleman. The results are obvious. And one thing about Coleman, one thing about Idris Abraham, they have a mean streak.
They absolutely do. Definitely would want to bump into these two guys in a dark alley. Oh, look at that, brother. Beautiful with an arm drag. Another arm drag.
Deep Ricky Steamboat.
Oh, look at this. Yes, very well said. A great change of Ricky Steamboat. Look at this. Beautiful.
Palm thrust there, very, very rarely.
Oh, the chop. To the top, look at this. Beautifully done. Well executed, Brett Banks here. Oh, look at this, he's figuring him out. To the corner. Beautiful with a European uppercut. Here comes Joe Coleman, big forearm from Tyson Dukes.
All four men in the ring here going at it. Dukes and Banks having control as they have through much of the opening of this contest.
Wow, Tyson Dukes, Brett Banks in full control here. Here we go, where we're going to see a double noggin knocker. Into the buckle.
Boy, the referee has totally lost control of this one. He needs to get Dukes and Banks in line.
What are you talking about? Beautiful, are you kidding me? And they roll out of the ring.
Well, Banks and Dukes there, you know, I'm fine with using the five count to its full effect, but the two of them in there for it had to be 30, 40 seconds. Really here, really referee here, Nick Wiley should have disqualified Banks and Dukes. If we had a Border City Wrestling official, this would be totally
Ladies and
different.
Gentlemen, keep your eyes peeled. Here he goes. He got him. to the top rope. Tyson Dukes now. Oh, he got him. Ladies and gentlemen, unbelievable.
You know, the match should be confined within the ring. Abraham Coleman outside gathering themselves, and Dukes and Banks illegally taking the fight outside.
Wonderful high flying. Here we go. One, two, how did Abraham kick out of that?
Boy, I'll tell you what, Banks was so high, I think he could have kissed the lights.
Jeez, you got some air on that one. Beautiful tag team action, ladies and gentlemen. Some of the best professional wrestling you will see anywhere on the planet. These guys are top notch.
Coleman still on the outside here, leaving Idris Abraham in a very precarious position in the ring while Dukes and Banks tag freely in and out, 2-on-1.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tyson Dukes, of course, competed in the cruiserweight division. Look at that, Joe Coleman, that snake. He grabbed him by the foot while he went to the ropes. Oh, look at that.
Oh, you think it's totally fine when Banks and Dukes take things outside of the ring, but when Joe Coleman simply injects himself into the match, as we almost get a count of three by Abraham there, simply injects himself into the match in a minor way, somehow you take great offense to that, Ice. Just another time where you're proving your bias. Now Abraham and Coleman getting an opportunity to use the advantage 2-on-1, but I'm sure that's totally wrong when they do it, although it's fine to you, Ice, when Banks and Dukes do it.
What are you talking about? Look at that, Joe Coleman's all over him right now. Wow, vicious elbow. Joe Coleman is a monster of a man. Picks him up. Humongous on that lower back. It's called the lumbar region, by the way.
Wow, you actually learned something. Two. Oh, and Coleman almost keeping Dukes down for a three, and what a win it would be for Joe Coleman at this point in his career to pin such a decorated star like Tyson
Dukes. Absolutely. Look at that.
Look at the way that Coleman and Abraham tagging in and out, keeping the fresh man in, cutting the ring in half, much like we saw earlier with Clan Freedom, really doing a great job of isolating the one guy, Dukes, and keeping him away from the partner, Banks.
It's a smart move. He's got to keep him away from Abraham in full control, working on him. Look at this.
Abraham here, they just got Dukes down in the corner there and taking full advantage of that five count, just like I would.
Big chop. Oh, look at that, big boot. Tag is made, legal tag. Here comes Coleman. An amazing tag team contest, ladies and gentlemen.
Boy, I'll tell you what, I think we're seeing the beginning of a beautiful friendship here with Joe Coleman and Idris Abraham. The way they're working together is seamless.
Absolutely, I gotta give them the credit. Look at this, wow. Look at the strength and power. Beautifully executed from Joe Coleman. Almost a three.
You know, what a helpless feeling for Banks to be over there on the apron and not able to do anything to help his partner. I kind of love it.
Crowd is yelling, Dukes, Dukes, Dukes.
Coleman trying to cut off the air to the windpipe there at Tyson Dukes, but Dukes able to fight up to his feet.
Oh, what a big chop! On the ropes! Joe Coleman, wait a minute. Oh no, tell me he's not gonna do this.
Coleman just taking a break here, getting a little bit of a pump in.
Trying to show off. Oh, and he hit Brett Banks off the canvas.
Well, Banks shouldn't be standing there like an idiot.
Come on, referee, turn around. There's Abraham coming in. Jeez, look at this. It's disgusting. Double team. Wait a minute, you see that? He didn't even tag him.
Hey, did I heard it.
You heard it, you didn't see it.
My monitor was out. Well, that's your excuse all the time.
Well, it was technically out.
That's true. Idris Abraham here, total control, dominating Tyson Dukes, backing him into their home corner there.
Oh, look at
this. He's got his partner Coleman.
Big boots from Abraham. Well, look at this. He got him. It could be over. One, two, and almost a three. So close.
You know, one thing I got to point out, Joel Coleman, he needs to get back in the dojo working on his pinfalls, because you notice he keeps pinning Dukes with his back against Tyson's chest. If he would pin him chest to chest, hook the leg, attach it with the arm, I think he could hold Dukes down for the three.
That's the upper strength, the upper body. You got to get on him on that.
Oh, I'll get on him, but they're totally in control here, which is great to see. Idris Abraham here taking a full run at Dukes. Oh, what a forearm.
Oh, look at that. Unbelievable. To the corner. Tyson Dukes with a lariat, and he took his head right off.
Dukes with one shot fired here. That big lariat seems to have evened the odds. This is his opportunity if he can make that tag to Banks and get the fresh man in. But Idris Abraham making the tag there, and he gets Coleman in.
There's the tag. Brett Banks' tag. Coleman's tag. Fresh new man. Here he comes. Misses. Boom with a big forearm. He misses again. Another forearm. Look at this. Brett Banks. Oh. Oh, no, 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 no. Brett Banks ain't going to have any of that. He psyched him out. Beautifully done. The savvy of Brett Banks. Up. Are you kidding me? With an unbelievable standing dropkick for Brett Banks.
What unbelievable athletic display by Banks here. He's been rocking Coleman. Abraham still recovering in the corner, and this is Banks' opportunity to take this thing home.
Here he goes to the corner now. Wait a minute. Look at this. Oh, my God. Come on. Come on, referee. And he kicks out.
I think the little bit of delay there with the Abraham going for the cover when he wasn't the legal man might have cost them a chance for the victory there.
All I know is that these guys are not nice guys. Abraham and Coleman, that was some sneaky maneuvers. Into the buckle. Hey, missed! Tag is made! Tyson Dukes, the legal man! Here he goes, look at this! Bomb into the back!
Oh, and a cowardly knee to the back by Dukes.
Look at this. Beautiful suplex!
Dukes now fired back up there. He's got Coleman reeling. What's he going here? Spinning him around and flipping him. What?
Look at this. Wait a minute. He's going to make him top. Right here.
He's got him in a crossface.
It could be over. Crowd is screaming top.
I think Coleman may have tapped there.
Tyson got him outside the ring. You mean Abraham hit the elbow? Wait a minute. This could be over right now. It could be lights out for Joel Coleman. His partner's outside with an injury. Brett Banks to the top rope. He gets him on that elbow. Here we go.
He's going for sliced bread.
He got him. Hook the leg. One, two.
And great, great ring positioning there by Abraham, getting in there and breaking up the fall.
Tyson Dukes throwing him outside the ring. He's coming over. Abraham's outside the ring. Tyson Dukes, they're going at it in the ring. Coleman, Brett Banks.
Oh, and into the post.
Into
Abraham
the steel
just ran.
Pole.
Just run Dukes into the post.
He may have knocked Tyson Dukes right out.
Brett Banks now back in the ring, picking Joel Coleman up here.
Look at this. Look at the garbage from Abraham. Absolute filth. Did you see that? He got him.
Fat burner right there.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the team of Joe Coleman and Idris Abraham.
What an unbelievable contest here representing Border City Wrestling. Tyson Dukes, a former heavyweight champion in BCW, former multiple-time tag team champion, Brent Banks, a former tag team champion. But they fall to the new team, the genetic jackpot, Joe Coleman, Idris Abraham. I love it. This is a good night here, George.
A huge miscarriage of justice, ladies and gentlemen. Tyson Dukes, Brett Banks, I'm sure they'll be back to fight again. Your winners, Abraham and Coleman, Border City Wrestling, putting on a fantastic matchup with this Ontario Series Super Show. What an amazing matchup. Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with more action.
this next match is our special Destiny World Wrestling Showcase match, featuring the stars of Destiny World Wrestling, featured right here at the Don Kolob Arena. And it is for the Destiny World Wrestling Heavyweight Championship! Introducing first, the challenger. From the Playboy Mansion, weighing in at 235 luscious pounds, Gianni Playboy!
Gianni Playboy here making his way to the ring in this contest that features two athletes that are so good they should not be representing Destiny Wrestling.
Wow. Did you just say that?
I think I did.
Gianni Playboy! A huge name in Destiny World Wrestling. He's doing a lot of great things. The so-called ladies' man.
Why do you say so-called? I've seen Playboy have to fight him off. He's got to find back doors to sneak out of. The women chase him around 24 hours a day.
Well, you've seen it. I haven't. He's going to be taking on the world champion, recently crowned.
Man who cheated to win the title.
Stop it, he did not.
RJ City should still be champion.
Come on, Psycho Mike Rollins, baby. It's a new era in Destiny World Wrestling, babe.
And his opponent, from Psychoville, weighing in at 221 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the reigning, defending Destiny World Heavyweight Champion, Psycho Mike Rollins!
Well, I don't know if Mike could be any more psycho than our ring announcer here on that introduction. Mike Rollins, credit where credit is due. A talented wrestler. He is your Destiny champion, but not for long, because RJ City or Congo Kong will take him out. That's right, but you know what? Maybe Playboy will take him out here tonight. Maybe he'll take you out. Slap him, Playboy. He's been saying bad things about you all
night. I have not.
Night.
I have
You
not.
Have to. I've got it on tape.
You stop it. Psycho Mike Rollins doing a dance, having fun with these fans. But he's got to keep his eye on the prize. He's got to keep that title. And Playboy will take an opportunity.
I think he's going to blow his nose in that Destiny shirt.
He is not. He's probably going to get one of these great fans.
He should blow his nose in it.
Gee, they're going to rip that shirt.
That's all it deserves.
Stop it.
Boy, the crowd squarely behind Psycho Mike here tonight as he defends his title, I believe, for the first time here, Ice.
Yep, absolutely. Referee Harry D calling in the Playboy so he could show him the belt and get this match underway.
You know, Ice, I'm shocked. I thought since Rollins is one of your pet projects, you'd throw an easy opponent to him. But I got to say, you're putting him in the ring there with a real competitor because the Playboy is the real deal.
I know what you mean by pet project. I mean, he won it fair and square. There it is. The title is on the line. Destiny. Will the Playboy be the new Destiny World Champion right here tonight?
I sure as hell hope so.
I hope not.
All right, our Destiny feature here about to get underway. We got Psycho Mike Rollins. We got the Playboy. And we got the official bell here.
Here we go.
Playboy here can't get distracted here by the antics of Rollins or by the chants of the fans, because this is his opportunity here to seize the gold at the Super Series.
There it is, ladies and gentlemen, about to lock up. Tolerable tie-up here. Playboy now. Big, big, strong man, by the way. Don't take away any credit from the Playboy. He'll take an opportunity if he can. Take advantage of it for that win. There they go. We'll even give him a clean break. Oh, come on. He pushed him.
I like that. The referee's got to back Rollins up.
He is. Look at that. He's doing it. He's doing it.
Yeah, begrudgingly.
Stop it.
Yeah, this crowd doing their best to psych out the Playboy, but I don't think it's going to work. Playboy's been all around the country. He's had some great opportunities early here in his career. Maybe none bigger here tonight where he could seize the 10 pounds of gold.
Here we go. Colorable time now. From behind. Well, look at this. Playboy. Well, not giving him time to celebrate. The Playboy pottering out now. Hey, come on. Get in the ring. Psycho Mike not going to take any antics from the Playboy. Look at this. He's chasing him with the ladder or the step up.
Yeah, I think Rollins here playing right into Playboy's hands here. Playboy here trying to get Rollins off his game, using some stall tactics here, slow the momentum, and I think that's a smart maneuver. Rollins now squeezing down on that side headlock of Playboy here. Playboy here with the wrist lock, with the waist lock in kind here, trying to control Rollins as he backs him into the rope.
Waist lock. Oh, look at this. He keeps dancing. He's got to concentrate. Oh! Oh! Oh, the big chop from Psycho Mike. Another chop. Another big chop.
You know, why does it not shock me that you like to when one man grabs another man's behind?
Big, beautiful shoulder block. Psycho Mike Rollins in full control. That's why he's the champ. Big knee to the back of the head. There we go. One. Almost a two.
You know, it's amazing, Ice, how many of your favorites hit their opponent when they're not facing them.
Would you stop that?
Playboy driving Rollins into the corner now, and now following up with shoulders to the stomach here. Beautiful European uppercut.
Beautiful European uppercut.
I think I just said that, Ice.
I'm repeating, it was beautiful. Look at this. Whoa, Psycho Mike. Wow, setting the Playboy outside the ring. Very dangerous. Oh! Unbelievable action outside the ring.
Psycho Mike here with a big dive to the floor. What an impressive move for a man of his size.
That was absolutely unbelievable. Johnny Playboy not having any luck. Are you kidding me? Did you see that?
Yeah, I saw that Playboy was in the corner and Rollins wouldn't back up. He was threatening him. He was coming at him in a threatening manner. And much like in Florida, a state where you have the right to defend your ground, Playboy defended his ground.
That was disgusting. That was an illegal maneuver.
Playboy now in control, got the two count there. Now we have an opportunity to see what Playboy can do when he has control of the action.
Beautiful dropkick from Psycho Mike. Sorry, the Playboy. Playboy.
Unbelievable vertical leap there by Playboy. You know, it's amazing the moves that both of these competitors have been able to do for men of their size to be able to move the way they have. It's unbelievable here.
Absolutely. Look at that, the Playboy. Oh, he's doing his dancing.
I think at this point in time, Playboy should dance a little less and fight a little more.
I agree.
This is for the heavyweight championship.
Look at these two. Both big, huge individuals. Whoa, look at this. Big, beautiful suplex. Well executed, to his credit, I have to say. He's in full control.
Playboy a little late and lackadaisical on the cover here. He doesn't seem to be taking this seriously enough for me. Now he's got that chin lock there, trying to cut the air off the Rollins. Playboy's had control of the action here for the last few minutes here. He's got it. This is time for him to be going in for the kill here.
Absolutely. Big forearm from Johnny Playboy. Johnny Playboy, so arrogant and cocky, likes to go to Los Angeles, hang out at the mansion with all these ladies. He only likes to, you got to see his rider. A rider, ladies and gentlemen, something we get with a contract, requesting all kinds of unthinkables, unspeakables, what he wants to participate in tonight's contest. Wants to get picked up in a limousine.
Rollins with a big drop kick of his own here.
There he goes, at the opportunity for Psycho Mike. He's got to take full advantage. Big close line. Look at this. Up. He got him. Beautifully done. Well executed.
What a backdrop by Mike Rollins here. Back up and in control.
There he goes. Up and over. Psycho Mike not having any part of it. So savvy. Such wing awareness. Look at this. Beautifully done. Off the ropes. He got him. Rolls out the ring. Wait a minute. He's going to the top. Oh, he's dancing. I gotta love it. Psycho Mike. He is like a cat. Oh, look at this. He got him. One, two, almost a three count.
Playboy able to get that shoulder up and keep himself here in a fight. You know, the amount of punishment that Playboy's taken here in the last couple of minutes, he's got to turn this thing around quickly or he's going to succumb to a pinfall.
Psycho Mike! You got to love Psycho Mike, man. What a great champion.
You do not have to like Psycho Mike.
Come on. Who doesn't like Psycho Mike?
I don't.
You don't like anybody.
I like Playboy just fine.
You don't even like your parents.
I love my mother and my mother loves me.
Stop it. Here we go. Look at this. The referee! Wait a minute! The referee, when he picked him up, got hit! Big super kick! Are you kidding me? Don't let it finish like this!
And the Playboy with the cover. That Harry Deed not making the pinfall. We should be counting 4, 5, 6. My God, that's better than King Kong Bundy!
This is horrible! What a miscarriage of justice if he wins the belt! I can't believe it! The referee is... The fans are cheering on Psycho Mike. What are you doing? What are you doing?
He deserves that belt. I see pin Rollins for a 6 or 7 count.
Leave that belt there. You leave that belt right there. Johnny Playboy taking the belt. Come on, referee. Don't let this end like this. What a horrible atrocity if he wins the belt here tonight. Oh, my. I am disgusted. Disgusted. Absolutely disgusting. What a travesty of justice here.
We could have a new champion crowned right here. The Playboy. Oh my God, Rollins kicking out.
Psycho Mike kicks out, thank the Lord. I couldn't bear to stand. A new champion, the things I'd have to deal with in the office with the Playboy. Come on, Psycho Mike.
Playboy looking to finish him off here.
Oh, he caught his foot. He caught the super kick. He gets him. Wait a minute, his finish. Beautifully done. One.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, and still Destiny World Wrestling Heavyweight Champion, Psycho Mike Rollins!
You know, Ice, I gotta say, in a weird way, I'm kind of glad that Psycho Mike Rollins retained the championship.
Wow, I can't believe you said that.
Because that way, Congo Kong can crush his skull and take the championship and bring it home to where it belongs with me.
I can't believe it, man. That's going to be a dark day in Destiny World Wrestling if Congo Kong brings the belt to the D'Amore family. That's going to be unbelievable, by the way. Check it out. Destiny World Wrestling presents Carnage, the two-year anniversary, January 22nd. Psycho Mike defends his title against Kongo Kong. Wait a minute. Look at this. Psycho Mike. What's he doing?
See, now he's mocking Playboy. This is sickening.
What? He's making him dance. Oh! Are you kidding me?
What the hell are we looking at?
This is beautifully done.
And you're totally fine with that, Ice. Playboy's showing good sportsmanship, willing to help his opponent celebrate a victory that he didn't deserve. Stop and you think him. It's okay to kick him in the stomach and then drop him on his head again. It's sickening. Ice.
Unbelievable.
Sickening.
I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, being accompanied by his compatriots from the compound, Smiles and Buck Gunderson, from Kurdistan, weighing in at 275 pounds, the Beast from the Middle East, Karrueche!
I can't believe it. I thought when the Iceman left, I was going to have some peace. And instead, I'm joined at this time by a gentleman, and I use that term lightly, who may be even worse than the Iceman, Ray Bernardo.
Oh, actually, I thought it was an honor to be sitting beside you.
It is an honor for you, but it's an insult for me.
Oh, come on.
But I'll tell you what, Ray, we're going to make our way through it. And look at this man coming to the ring, Karrueche. What a true beast this is. One of the baddest dudes to come out of Battle Arts Academy. He's the monster of the Don Koloff Arena. Karrueche, he's got Smiley, he's got Buck Gunderson, and the BCW champion, Cody Deaner, is going to have his hands full.
Yeah, but what I understand is this. Like Cody is a fantastic wrestler. I've seen him wrestle. What is the monster?
And his opponent. From the Deaner Dynasty Estate, weighing in at 213 pounds, Mr. DDT, Cody Deaner!
Well, the BCW Heavyweight Champion Cody Deaner making his way to the ring. I do not like this guy. I think he's dirty. I think he's underhanded. I think he's a horrible representation for my company.
I think he's great.
Well, you would. He is the heavyweight champion, maybe not for long. And you ask why Karrueche would need these two gentlemen in his corner? That's because Deaner's a cheat, Harry D's a cheat, Anthony Corelli's a cheat, George Iceman's a cheat, just like you're a cheat, Bernardo.
Oh, wow, come on, Scott. I guess we're not calling this right down the middle, are we?
I'm calling it right down the middle the way I see it, but everybody else around me is biased.
Oh, so I guess everyone else around me is blind, right?
Listen here, Pally. Just because I'm paranoid doesn't mean that everybody's not out to get me.
Wow. True words spoken by the one and only Scott DeMore.
And I'll tell you up, what an amazing matchup we have here, Ray, at the Ontario Super Series here. Battle Arts Academy playing host to Battle Arts Wrestling, Destiny Wrestling, and Border City Wrestling. We got the BCW champion against the monster of the Battle Arts Academy, Karrueche. What an unbelievable interpromotional matchup.
Yeah, this is great. And you know what? The funny thing is, look at the physique on Deaner. You know what? He's really not scared. He's ready to go.
Well, I'll tell you what. You know, Cody Deaner, because of some of his antics, which do make me sick, people overlook what a talented wrestler he is, and they also overlook this is a well-put-together guy.
He's looking right at you, eh?
You worry about defending that title. Don't you worry about me, Cody Deaner.
Uh-oh. We got DeMore. Oh, DeMore is going up there. This is not a good sign for Deaner. Wow. I cannot believe that Scott DeMore is getting involved in this match already. This is crazy. Is this a 4-on-1? You got the compound and DeMore shaking hands. I cannot believe DeMore just shook hands with the leader of the compound, Buck Gunderson. Wow. Honestly, you're unbelievable, Scott. You're unbelievable. I cannot believe what you just did.
You know, I'm sitting here trying to do my job, Ray. The job that I'm paid for, do a job that I do better than anybody else, and that's commentate. And I got Cody Deaner coming here and yelling obscenities at me. So I just went up there to set him straight and to give a little pep talk to the Monster Crew.
Wow. I still can't believe you went up there. I can't believe this.
Look at the strength on Carew. Don't you worry about me. You worry about that Monster Carew who just threw Cody Deaner down like a rag doll.
Gosh, you know what, Scott? That guy is huge, and he is strong. He is powerful. Now, Cody's got the odds against him with the rest of the compound on the outside, and clearly with you sitting here.
The odds are stacked against Carew because he's got that crooked official, Harry D, in the ring. He's got Corelli sitting ringside, who's a cheat. And we've got everybody conspiring against Carew, but I'm here to do my best to make sure he gets his due.
I can see that.
Well, I'll tell you what, Carew, he's a graduate of Battle Arts Academy, not the Can-Am Dojo, but I would still be honored to have a man like Carew hold our Border City Wrestling Heavyweight Championship.
Wow. That, you know what? That's a great endorsement coming from a man like you. That's for damn sure.
And look at Deaner bouncing off Carew like a little child.
Look at the size and the power of Carew. I cannot believe it. Wow.
I don't think Deaner's going to get very far with those. Carew eating those, and it's just making him stronger.
That's for sure.
Deaner trying to smash Carew's head into the buckle, and look at Carew just laughs at him and says, plant one right here on the chin.
Wow. And well, Deaner, he's going to give it to him, that's for sure. Well, here we go. Here's the windup. Wow, right? Wow. Now, that's a move. I like that.
Well, of course you would. It's an illegal move. He poked Carew in the eyes. He's using those closed fists to attack him, so, of course, it's totally fine with you, Ray.
Well, he's fighting. You're fighting a monster. What do you do when you fight a monster?
Ideally, you'd follow the rules. Oh, look, Deaner's got Carew rocking there, but Carew staying on his feet.
Wow.
Deaner with a couple of big clotheslines here, trying to rally the crowd behind him.
Here we go. Wow. Oh, my goodness. What a shoulder tackle by him.
And Cody Deaner managing to chop down the giant Carew. Buck Gunderson's got to get Carew back on track here.
You got to watch out for smiles. That guy, look at him. Look, he's trying to grab his leg, Scott. Call a spade a spade. He's going to grab his leg.
Oh, so it's totally fine when Cody Deaner pokes Carew in the eyes, but a smiley merely grabs a foot all of a sudden. It's a national incident.
Of course it is. That's cheating, Scott.
Yeah, so is a poke in the eyes. But look at Carew now all over Cody Deaner, attacking him with rights and forearms, now backing up.
This is not good for Cody.
Big avalanche splash in the corner. Carew with a nice lateral press. Getting a good 2.5 count there.
Harry D's right in there. What a great official that guy is, eh?
Oh, stop it. I'm sick and tired of all you guys kissing Harry D's butt.
Come on, now Carew's clearly not going to... Oh, he obeyed the count. I'm actually shocked he did that.
Well, of course he did, because he's following the rules.
Come on, you can't see that.
You get 5 seconds. If you use 4, that's totally fine.
You did not see what the compound just did outside to Cody?
No, I was busy keeping an eye on Corelli over here, because he looked like he was going to interfere.
Now, you're telling me Corelli would interfere?
Corelli interferes all the time.
Corelli's a straight-up guy in this business.
Oh, stop it.
I wish I could say the same for you.
Anthony Corelli's just like you. He'd rather climb a tree and tell a lie than stand on the ground and tell the truth. Carew totally in control here. And I mean, Bernardo, and I'll use this term lightly, my friend, I think maybe we could have a new BCW champion.
It looks like that, doesn't it? Well, how well do you think Carew would do if the compound wasn't out here? And actually, if you didn't go up there and try and help them about 8 minutes ago.
What? I went up there and I just gave a pep talk to Carew.
Oh, you were taking your vest off. You were mad.
I shook Buck Gunderson's hand and wished them well, because that's what a gentleman does, Bernardo.
So how about Cody? You don't wish him well?
I do not wish him well. About the best I can do is wish he doesn't get hit by a bus.
Wow, I cannot believe that. I bet you Corelli would wish him well.
Yeah, Corelli would cheat for him.
Because I would wish
him. Oh, Dieter hooking for the DDT, but getting driven into the corner by Carew.
Now, this guy, Scott, honestly, you're a brain in the wrestling business. This guy, Carew, is definitely a monster. He's a force to be reckoned with in any organization.
Yeah, Carew, a real up-and-comer here. He's been doing great in Battle Arts Wrestling. He's made a couple of good showings in Destiny, and now he's got a shot at the BCW gold.
Look at what's happening outside.
Carew's got something in his eye. Look, Harry D actually checking
him. Never
mind.
Look what's happening outside, Scott.
All I saw was smiles rolling Diener into the ring. Two. Oh, so close.
Two count.
You know, Diener was outside of the ring, smiles, did the gentlemanly-like thing, and rolled him back in so he didn't
What's
get
Buck doing
out.
Up there? What is he doing up there?
He's just giving instructions to Carew. You know, Bernardo, if you know how to do your job, you'd know that sometimes when you're ringside, when you're a manager, when you're guiding somebody's career, right. You have to actually do that, guide them, shout them some encouragement, give them some instructions, some guidance, and that's what Gunderson's doing.
Oh, come on, you actually thought he's giving him guidance right now?
Well, I do, and look, Carew backing up here. He's winding up. We're going to see another big avalanche splash, baby.
And he, wow, he missed. Good job, Cody. Come on, Cody. You got the fans behind you. Give it to, there you go. Now there's an off. Even Corelli's chanting for him right now.
Of course, he's biased. Diener with all those closed fist blows, and Harry D has no problem with it. That's got to be 15, 20 illegal punches.
Yeah, here we go. Come on, Cody. You can do it. There we go. Now there's a fair wrestling move. A clothesline.
Maybe the first legal move that Diener's used in this matchup. And now look at him pandering to these moronic fans. I hope it costs him.
Oh, come on. The moronic fans?
Moronic fans.
Some of these people actually came here to see you.
Well, they should. I'm the only good thing around here most days.
Oh, my God.
Oh, and Carew's got him. He's picking him up. He's got him in a power slam. This could be it.
Oh, my God.
He hooks the leg. Two.
Attaboy, Cody, come on. You can do this, Cody.
You saw Harry D was he was slow on that count.
No, he
Whenever
was not.
Cody Diener goes for a count, it's 1, 2, 3. When Carew does, it's 1.
No, come
two.
On.
It's
God.
Sickening.
Come on.
Buck Gunderson now getting up. He's upset with the count as well.
What's he do? Hit the referee?
Oh, he's stop speculating on what's gonna happen here.
Oh. Wow. That was good. Good job, Buck.
Gunderson hitting Carew with that kendo stick.
I hope Cody wins this match.
Of course you do, because you're biased.
And I speak for Corelli when I say
Diener
that.
Diener hooks it and hits
what
the
a DDT.
Where's Smiles? Get in there, Smiles.
One, two, it's all over, Scott.
Here is your winner, Cody Diener.
You know what, Scott? I got to shake this guy's hand. This guy's amazing.
Well, you got to leave because you're in our main event too, so go get your jabrones ready for that.
Wow.
And go kiss Diener's butt just like you do Corelli's and Isis and everybody else is around. And maybe get me a sandwich while you're at it.
I'll make you a sandwich. And Corelli, Corelli is not biased. He's straight up. I wish you were straight up.
I'm going to get, don't you worry about me, Diener. Oh, yeah, Bernardo there going out, kissing up. Cody Diener lives to fight another day. Hate to say it, job well done by Diener, and another amazing match here at the Ontario Super Series featuring Border City Wrestling, Destiny World Wrestling, and Battle Arts Wrestling here at the Don Koloff Arena. What an unbelievable night, and we still got two great main events.
Our next contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Tokyo, Japan, weighing in at 181 pounds, Kyosuke Okuda!
Okuda making the trip all the way from Japan here. Highly thought of grappler, got great striking ability, and he's going to be here in the Don Koloff Arena in our semi-main event.
I've been watching him train for the last 2 weeks, and he's an animal. And grappling, Muay Thai, now transitioning to professional wrestling, he's going to be a very dangerous man to be against.
Boy, I'll tell you what, I hate to agree with you, especially so early in you joining the broadcast, but I watched him working over some of the bags backstage, and what unbelievable technique and power he has.
I believe he's a very highly decorated college wrestler in Japan as well.
And his opponent, from Palm Beach, Ontario, weighing in at 186 pounds, D-Man Daniel Parker!
From Palm Beach, Ontario, here he comes, the Beach Boy, D-Man Parker.
Well, Okuda's certainly going to have his hands full here as he steps into the ring with Parker, the D-Man here. I don't know, got some flashy gear. We'll see if his moves hold up to it. I'm calling gimmick infringement on all the Maple Leafs. That's kind of my deal, but Okuda may be going to teach him a lesson about that.
Wow, he didn't like the fact that he got in his face.
I begrudgingly say this about you, Corelli. You've got a background in mixed martial arts. You're a decorated professional wrestler. You know, I don't know what D-Man's doing, walking up and getting right in somebody's face. Okuda should have punched him right in the mouth.
D-Man's been training pretty hard, and pound for pound, he's actually a very good grappler. He just needs to put on a few pounds to fight with the big dogs.
Yeah, we've got cruiserweight action here, and as you pointed out, D-Man a little bit on the lanky side, but has that tendon strength, as they say. Okuda a little thicker, a little stockier. Both of them got great techniques, so we should be in for a good one.
What you're seeing here is a classic demonstration of the battle arts style that I fell in love with in Japan.
And you got both men here, they're kind of in that feeling out process. I mean, when you're in there and you've got these guys that have such a good amateur background, got a mixed martial arts background, you don't just see the regular collar elbow tie-ups, you see the different ways that they engage each other, the multiple techniques there. Beautiful knee bar by Okuda here early.
Very smooth transition.
Okuda not letting go there.
Trying to put on some pressure after it.
Oh!
Cannot touch an official.
Boy, I'm very surprised that Nick Wiley here didn't call for the disqualification, because I know that's something that's usually not in any way, shape, or form tolerated here.
It's just a bad investment, you know. He's going to be, obviously have something against you the whole match now.
Well, I mean, I know something about having the officials against you, because I've had the deck stacked against me here in Destiny at the Don Koloff Arena many, many times because of Iceman's shady dealings, because of you sticking your nose in where it doesn't belong, and I hope that Okuda doesn't fall victim to the same type of biasness.
Come on! He put the submission on this time, dragged him in the middle of the ring. He's been playing a little bit of a chess game here when it comes to leg locks, ankle locks. Oh, D-Man reversed it. Forced him to get the ropes.
Yeah, D-Man able to sink in a nice ankle lock there. And Okuda's got to be careful here because... Okuda or Okuda? Okuda.
Okuda.
Okuda Matana.
D-Man has been training with Mr. Ishikawa for over 3 years now. That's why you see his grapplers.
Well, I mean, as I explained earlier in the broadcast, Ishikawa-san, a hugely respected, wildly respected man, not just in professional wrestling, but in mixed martial arts all around the world. And anyone that's been training with him has to have great techniques.
Yeah, that's really his gimmick, you know, is that his technique and attention to detail is second to none.
Great grappling display here by both men. Seeing a combination of strength. Oh, going there for the cross arm breaker. Okuda able to keep his hands locked and then roll it up and get a two count on D-Man. Now, Corelli, let me ask you, Okuda here, is he out? Yeah, I hear that he's out of the Inoki Dojo in Tokyo?
Yeah, trains from with IJF, and they sent him here to train with Mr. Ishikawa because of his, his well-respected.
Oh! Wow. Look at those kicks! Oh, Oh, he's got the rear naked choke on D-Man there. He's got him at D-Man making the ropes.
He knew he couldn't get out. He looked for the ropes immediately, knowing that that was going to be his only way to get out.
Yeah, and Okuda doing the smart thing and holding on for the full four count there after D-Man got the ropes, taking full advantage of the latitude.
Every submission now is held on a little extra.
Yeah, for those of our fans that don't know, the Inoki Dojo in IGF there is founded and operated by Antonio Inoki, who's just about the most famous wrestler potentially in the history of Japanese wrestling.
Whoa, here they go back and forth. We're going to see who has the tougher jaw. God, those are right on the jaw.
Wow, look at them exchanging those big forearms back and forth.
Thunderous kick to the sternum.
Boy, the quickness and the snap combined with the power of these kicks from Okuda, sure those seem to be wearing down D-Man.
D-Man is in trouble. Ooh.
Boy, you can just hear that snap on those kicks.
He has sustained some serious damage.
Okuda here, you know, he's displayed some great grappling. Now he's really showing the force that he can put into those kicks, and he's striking from all kinds of different angles.
You know when your cable goes out and you get that staticky thing? That's what D-Man's seeing right now with these kicks.
Oh, snap Rana and a roll through to a pin. D-Man gets a two count.
Wonderful hurricane on the floor.
And notice Okuda there doesn't just graze him with the drop kick. He drives way through him and drives D-Man into the corner. And big Yakuza kick there.
This match is turning out to be everything I hoped it would be. It's awesome.
Now Okuda showing he's just as deadly with his fists as he is with his feet. And his knees.
Damn. That was impactful. His shin right into his chest.
You know, what an unbelievable display here of an array of skills as Okuda goes there for the pin. Almost gets it on D-Man. You know, I myself, much like you have, Pirelli, I've worked with a lot of Japanese talent training in the dojo. Kushida, who's a top star in New Japan, Akira Lijin, Masayuki Kono, Soya, all these guys, world champions in Japan, and certainly Okuda here is displaying a great traditional Japanese skills here.
Yeah, he's definitely representing that style very well.
D-Man stealing a play out of Maple Leaf Muscle, Petey Williams' book there, doing the tornado twist around into the Russian leg sweep, and he's got Okuda down, and this is really maybe D-Man's chance to mount some offense.
This is it. Hopefully momentum has shifted in his favor. He can get up and capitalize. I mean, these guys put it all on the line.
Really seldom right and wrong again, Pirelli. I really hope he doesn't take advantage because I want to see Okuda here take control. I'd like to see him kick D-Man's head right off. Oh!
Win the bridge. Excellent. Oh, my. That was close.
Man, great German suplex. Gets a two count. Now he's going in the cross arm breaker. Floating over. What's he got here? Flipping through.
Nice.
Oh, he's got the cross face with the hammer locked arm. Okuda's in trouble here if he doesn't make the ropes. He's close, but he's not quite there, but he gets there.
Oh, what determination. He didn't stop. He was in trouble. He knew where the ropes were, and he got there.
That's
got
to be demoralizing, no pun intended, for D-Man there to sink that kind of move in. A move that I thought Okuda might have been trapped in and still maybe able to make the ropes. It's got to be frustrating.
Crowd at the Don Koloff Arena. Oh, their appreciation.
Yeah, and Okuda with the rear naked choke here. He's got him, sets him up. Kick right there to the neck.
Running kick to the chest. And D-Man is still able to kick out.
What great fighting spirit, as they call it in Japan, displayed by D-Man. Oh, side salto suplex by Okuda.
Lord of mercy.
Boy, notice how Okuda there hooked the key lock there. And when D-Man was able to kick out, flipped it right over into an arm bar. Look at this, submissions back and forth.
He was waiting for
We got a knee bar from Okuda, and that's it.
I didn't see that coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner is the result of a submission, Keisuke Okuda!
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to have to apologize to Okuda. I think I butchered his name a half a dozen times during that match, but it's because I was so excited, couldn't keep up with the action between him and D-Man. Back and forth. I tip my hat to D-Man, not really a fan of his in some ways, but he went out there, showed fighting spirits, showed some great techniques. But our visitor from the land of the rising sun, Okuda, victorious here. Beautiful knee bar.
Yeah, I'm feeling a little bit like a proud papa here, seeing D-Man perform at that level and having his game raised by this young Japanese superstar.
Yeah, and there we see a handshake there, a show of sportsmanship. Okuda's showing that D-Man has earned his respect here. And I gotta say, I'm sure that Inoki and everybody there at IGF, very happy here that Okuda's here at Battle Arts Academy and training under Ishikawa. And begrudgingly, I say,
how about a round of applause for both competitors, ladies and gentlemen? This match is the main event of the evening, and it is a Survivor Series style six-man elimination tag team match. Introducing first, accompanied by their manager, Pasquale DePapa, the team of Battle Arts Heavyweight Champion, Randy Rain, Battle Arts Light Heavyweight Champion, Dustin Quicksilver, and J.P. Morgado!
Pasquale DePapa leading his troops, property of Pasquale, property of DePapa, I stand corrected. And look at this, what a formidable group making their way down here.
Yes, I hate the fact that he's my landlord. It bothers me every day.
Ah, Pasquale DePapa. Done, Pasquale DePapa.
So good to see you. Hey. That makes sense. It makes total sense now.
You know, I think it's great that Pasquale DePapa is able to lower himself and come down here with the commoners and step in here into the Don Koloff Arena. He collects the rent, but he comes down and he graces all of these schlebs here in the crowd with his appearance before them.
Last week he was there was an article on him in Forbes, and he was of course carrying the magazine around, showing everybody the article. Yeah, we saw it.
Well, he's kind of a proud guy. You know how immigrants are. I mean, they come to this country, they do well, and they're proud of it.
And their opponents, being accompanied by Ray Bernardo, the team of Mike DeRossi, Randy Bino, and DJ!
Boy, I'll tell you what, and to juxtapose a good, hard-working immigrant success story like Pasquale DePapa, we got Ray Bernardo. He came here. When I first met him, he was a used car salesman. He doesn't sell cars anymore, but he's still a con man and a cheat.
Come on. He's an upstanding gentleman, a pillar of the community.
Stop it. He shorts you on the veal and you're sandwich. He screws up your front lawn if you hire him to do landscaping. He sells you a clunker of a car, and his guys cheat.
He's a good man. Come on.
Oh, my God.
You know, he has nothing but the best intentions for his roster. He does a lot for these kids. He helps them out.
You know, good intentions obviously quite often don't lead to success. Ray Bernardo, I have to admit, his guys have had some success, but when you talk about true success, you talk about the gold. And right now, you got Dustin Quicksilver, you got Randy Rain. They've got all the gold in Battle Arts Wrestling, and they belong to the camp. They are the property of DePapa.
Okay. Let's get to this.
You know, really, Corelli, in a way, you're sort of property of DePapa, too, because all your hard-earned money goes right in that man's pocket because you scrimp and you save and you work and you sweat, and then he gets to enjoy all the success of it when you hand over that fat rent check. You needed a better lawyer, my friend.
I can't stand the fact that I have to pay him rent. Trust me, it bothers me every day.
Oh boy, I'll tell you what, we've got a six-man Survivor Series style matchup here, and in tribute to the fact that we're here on Survivor Series weekend. It's the Ontario Super Series here, Border City Wrestling, Battle Arts Wrestling, and Destiny World Wrestling, all here in the Don Koloff Arena. You know, I had an opportunity on a few occasions. I was honored to meet Don Koloff, and great man, great wrestler, and a man of respect. And I think he would have liked Pasquale Di Papa.
That's going to be a very interesting meeting when Don Koloff meets Pasquale Di Papa.
Boy, I want to be a fly on the wall, but I don't want to get too close because that could be a real clash. All right, we got DJ and we got Dustin Quicksilver here starting this off. Elimination style matchup, so this is really an opportunity where you can get the odds in your favor if things go your way.
And these guys have history. There's been multiple occurrences with Mike DeRosti and Randy Ray, Mike DeRosti and JP.
So wait, what you're saying is Mike DeRosti has a problem. He can't get along with anybody.
Well, he gets along with his teammates.
That's because you ever heard of the term band of thieves? They collaborate together to cheat the good, hardworking people like the property of the Papa.
Guys jockeying for a position here. Like a couple of bucks locking horns.
You know, I was here when Morgano made his big return here and he joined the Pasquale Di Papa family. I think it was a great decision on his part, and I think it goes to show he's traveling with success. Di Papa's successful. They've got all the gold and they're here in our main event.
Beautiful arm drag. Twisting combination. It's very smooth. DJ's been training really hard. Morgano's having none of that. Hits him with a stiff forearm to the jaw.
Oh, DJ certainly no slouch. He's got great techniques. He works very hard. Obviously in tremendous physical condition.
He really likes these sequences of moves.
Yeah, but you know, sometimes flash isn't as important as substance. He did a lot of maneuvers there, but he came up with really next to nothing. And Morgano, they're able to reverse it into a good front face lock almost immediately.
Yeah, I definitely think he can take away some of the flair and have a little more success. Less is more, simple.
Oh, another good arm drag there by DJ.
I guess that's why he does all those moves, to show his speed and agility. Maybe to intimidate the opponent. Who knows?
Oh, we got a tag here. Wow, the darkest albino I've ever met now in the ring there with JP Morgano. Oh, beautiful hip toss there, judo nice. Style.
Some stiff kicks too. Randy's really been working on his fighting game.
Oh, another great judo hip toss. Only able to get a one count on lateral press. Now, Randy Bino's really got some great movement and technique there for such a large man.
Yeah, but he's a young kid too. He's only going to get better.
And Mike DeRosi here, the former Battle Arts heavyweight champion in there. Oh, Morgano gets out, and here we're going to get our first chance to see Quicksilver in here.
Morgano was smart, gave him one knee and booked it. Mike DeRosi is fresh, obviously, because he's coming in really fast.
Yeah, and I got to begrudgingly say that the Ray Bernardo camp there so far has had the majority of the success. Oh, DJ here with a sunset flip.
Again, getting a little too fancy.
Going for a bit. Oh! Wow, twisting suplex.
Damn, that was executed well.
Getting the first two count of the match here on Dustin Quicksilver. Ah, Bernardo needs to shut his mouth.
I wonder if Ray taught him that.
You've got to be kidding me.
Or maybe you showed him a video of it.
That's possible. Here he's really good with the YouTube.
Yeah.
Oh, and here we get our first chance to see the Battle Arts champion, Randy Ray. Great backbreaker by Rain.
He is just manhandling DJ. You forget sometimes how big Randy Rain is.
Yeah, Reigns just a massive superstar. Coming in there, and look, you see the Pasquale Di Papa camp with quick tags there. Reigns tags in Morgano. Beautiful. Beautiful flip into the ring there. Now we got an opportunity here. Maybe the property Di Papa here can isolate DJ on their half of the ring and start working him over.
Yeah, DJ has to get somebody fresh in there. He's taking quite a bit of a beating right now.
I mean, listen, Corelli, you got to give credit where it's due. Pasquale Di Papa has his troops fine-tuned, considering you threw this match at them with no advance notice and a really scummy move, I might add, and despite that, they're still out here dominating.
Well, I've had my eye on this match for quite some time, and it was just, you know, it was coming to a boil, and we're going to have to just settle it.
Oh, DJ around to his feet, trying to make the tag, but Morgano's got the foot.
Tag, here comes Randy Bino. He's pretty fresh.
Oh, and he got Quicksilver eating a couple of big clotheslines.
Wow.
Oh, big power slam by Bino.
Very explosive, had a lot of snap in that.
Yeah, Quicksilver probably wishing he wouldn't have took that tag from Morgano at this point.
Ooh, nobody home.
Oh, beautiful jackknife pin. Oh, what the hell? That looked like a pinfall to me. I don't know what Harry D's doing.
So his shoulder is out.
I don't know what the hell's going on here. I think you got to fix it again, Corelli, because the way I see it, the light heavyweight champion there, Dustin Quicksilver, had Bino pinned, and Harry D refused to count the pinfall.
Yeah, that was a weird thing that just happened there.
Yeah, Bino here now trying to make the best of second chances here, back in control. Irish whipping Quicksilver into the corner. Following in, but he eats the buckle. Quicksilver there, getting the 1-2-3, maybe a handful of tights.
And Randy Bino has been eliminated.
Wow, I didn't expect Randy to go out.
Well, Bino now, I mean, I think eliminated twice, but it only counts as one. And now Pasquale Di Papa's camp has the advantage here as it's 3-2. We've got DJ, we got Mike over there in Camp Bernardo. And
DJ is taking a beating already. He's like 1.5 guys.
Yeah, Randy Bino can hang his head in shame as he heads to the back. Don't look at me. Just bow to Don Di Papa there on your way out. Oh, look at him threatening a senior citizen like that. That's sickening.
Hey, come on. It's already hard enough to lose. You don't got to, you know, harp on the guy.
Without loss, there is no success. And maybe Randy Bino will learn that and work a little harder next time.
Yeah, he's going to come back better and stronger than ever.
Yeah, speaking of somebody who needs to work a little harder, Mike DeRossi there in a ring. He's been having some tough times of late. He's lost that championship. I know he's the number one contender, but that was a fluke. And now he's in there. Him and DJ are going to have to fight from underneath, 2-on-3.
Mike looks very strong. I can see in his grappling, he has a lot of physical strength. He's giving the guys a hard time to hold him down.
Now, Morgano's got some great techniques, but certainly giving up the size and strength advantage to DeRossi.
And Morgano is very crafty.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, Morgano here has been in here for the majority of the time for his team as well. I mean, he's maybe wanting to look to make a tag. Big tackle by DeRossi, cover. Doesn't even get a one count.
He ran him over. Here comes DJ. Let's see what he has in the tank, because earlier he took some damage.
Oh, what's he got here? Oh! Modified black hole slam type maneuver there. Gets him a two count.
Man, he almost hurt himself. It looked like he was going to land on his knee.
Yeah, I wasn't sure if he's going for a backbreaker there or a side slam. Oh! DJ eating a knee in the back there from Rain while the referee's distracted, and Morgano taking advantage of it. Oh, beautiful suplex there. Corey Funk style, hooks the leg, 2-3.
Whoa. No, wait.
DJ has been eliminated.
Damn, it's not looking good here for Ray Bernardo's team.
I think it looks great because I want to see my Zio Pasquale De Papa's team here have some success. It's about time that Bernardo Eats Crow and Mike DeRossi here now is going to have to fight 3-on-1.
Look at Randy Rain again, just rubbing it in.
Well, you know, DJ goes out there, he likes to be flashy, likes to use all those fancy moves, so that's fine. But at the end of the day, a good knee to the back and some good aggressive technique are successful the vast majority of the time.
Mike DeRossi, the numbers game already got the better of him.
Oh, look at that. Mike DeRossi just really getting abused in that corner. Hey, he can work his way to his corner. All he wants is nobody there to tag.
I don't know where he's going.
Maybe he's going to try to tag Bernardo, and I'd love to see Ray get his fat, stupid head in there and get it punched in.
That's not a good sign that he was going for his partner. He may have gotten his bell rung.
Mental toughness, not exactly DeRossi's strong point.
And now they're just chopping him down.
Oh, DeRossi underneath, rolling him up. Quicksilver.
Dustin Quicksilver has been eliminated.
Oh, DeRossi able to get Quicksilver out of there, but still 2-on-1. Morgano not giving him any chance to rest, jumping on him right away. He's still going to have to overcome Morgano and Rain if he wants to succeed, and that's a tough road to travel.
Yeah, especially with the damage he's taking now. It's just getting harder and harder. He's getting farther and farther away from success.
Yeah, see, right now he's in his own corner. Normally that'd be a safe haven, but he's got nobody there to help him.
Hey,
oh, look at Rain all over DeRossi.
These guys are too much for Harry D. He's obviously too trusting because he's turning his back to these guys, and you can't do that. They're just, they're jerks.
Oh, come on now. These are fine, upstanding gentlemen. They're out here. They're using great technique and superior intellect in order to wear down DeRossi.
Come on. Fight a man face to face. Don't give him a cheap shot when he's not looking.
You tell me I shouldn't hit a man when he's down, and I ask you, when's there a better time to hit a man?
Come on. Well, it depends what he did.
I'll tell you what, DeRossi, look at it. He's working his way to his corner, and that's going to do him nothing because he's got nobody there to tag, and these moronic fans and that jerk. Bernardo can't help him. Now Reggie Rain in and all over DeRossi right away.
This is not good for DeRossi. Or is it?
Boy, I'll tell you what, DeRossi firing off with those forearms. Oh, big side suplex.
I don't know where DeRossi got the second win from.
Oh! Look at the quickness by Rain there. Pick him up. Oh, beautiful exploder-style suplex by Randy Rain.
He threw him halfway across the ring.
Randy Rain, your Battle Arts Heavyweight Champion, is a monster. Yeah, I'll tell you what, maybe if Bernardo had half a brain, he'd tell DeRossi to throw the towel in.
And actually, it's not a bad idea. Live to fight another day because, you know, he might get hurt out here.
Oh, he slips out. Looked like Rain was going for the Rainmaker. Oh, now he's going for a sunset flip. Oh, DeRossi's pinned him down. Jackknife style. He got the three.
Randy Rain has been eliminated.
I can't believe it. Mike DeRossi having even the odds. And he's pinned the Battle Arts Heavyweight Champion.
He just pinned the Heavyweight Champion. That's going to be way heavyweight because they have a rematch coming up. Mike DeRossi is the number one contender.
He's the number one contender. And now that's the first time I've ever seen Randy Rain pinned here in Battle Arts. Unbelievable.
Yeah, I don't think I have either.
Well, I'll tell you what, DeRossi, Morgano, now the two surviving members of each team, but there can only be one survivor overall. Oh, Morgano to the floor. Mike DeRossi, is he going to? Oh, slide kick there.
Baseball slide, knocking down J.P. Morgano like a bowling pin.
Now the rope's not able to hold him within the confines there, but DeRossi rolling Morgano in. Morgano smartly rolling right back out.
Oh, need the old base and spring.
Boy, I'll tell you what veteran experience there by Morgano. He baits in, like you said, Mike DeRossi, because DeRossi's not too damn bright. and then throats him across the rope and gets the cover, too. DeRossi somehow able to kick out.
Yeah, he has to try and get it, catch his breath, and I think he got his bell rung, so he has to kind of, you know, regain his wits.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, DeRossi there, oh my God, one shot, and he's right out of the side headlock. Oh, double clothesline.
Both guys down, both guys down.
You know, interesting juxtaposition here between the two competitors. You got Mike DeRossi, younger, stronger, but vastly more inexperienced than the veteran, JP Morgano. So you've got experience versus strength and power, and you've got a mastermind like DiPapa versus a moron like Bernardo. Crowd not shockingly getting behind the morons.
Yeah, the crowd of the Del Coroff Arena definitely appreciates the heart shown by Mike DeRossi on a monthly basis.
Oh, DeRossi with a great series of forearms and then drives Morgano into the corner. Irish whips him into the far corner. Oh, big backdrop.
Look how worn out DeRossi is. That was like a desperation backdrop. He took everything he had just to do it.
Oh, big clothesline in the corner. I'll tell you what, I don't know how DeRossi still got fight left in. Oh, pulls him up with a big power slam.
I thought JP Morgado reversed that, then he kind of continued it into that power slam. Very nice transition.
On DeRossi here, setting up in the corner. I think this could be his patented spear. DeRossi sitting in that corner. I see the look of concern on DePapa's face. Morgano's got it. Morgano working his way up to the feet. He could be in real trouble here. He comes. Oh, DeRossi just destroys Harry D.
Oh, my God. JP Morgano moved out of the way. Harry D.
Boy, I'll tell you what. I've never been happier to see DeRossi hit a spear because it was on that jerk Harry D. And look, Morgano. He's got the knuckle dusters on his fist. Up. Spear. DeRossi going for the pin, but Harry D's out.
He could have won.
Bernardo can count all he wants, but it doesn't matter. Dustin Quicksilver here, out here, lays out Mike DeRossi, and thankfully takes out that jerk Bernardo.
He just punched right Bernardo.
Mike Quicksilver coming out here. He'd had enough of Bernardo and his yipping ring. Oh, big spear by DeRossi on Quicksilver. Boy, DeRossi just spearing everything in sight.
It's like spears must have been on sale.
Right now, but Randy Rain in here picks up DeRossi. He's got him set and ready for the Rainmaker. DeRossi slips out. Spear! Boy, I'll tell you what, DeRossi's laid out just about everybody under the sun now, including the referee. But boy, is he spent. Morgano's up. I think he's still got those knuckle dusters on his fist. Oh, and he lays out DeRossi.
Oh, my God. Not again.
DiPapa sitting there, reviving Harry D. We could have a winner.
Hiding the brass knuckles.
Two,
referee doesn't know.
Down. Three.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners. The team of Dustin Quicksilver, Randy Rain, and the sole survivor, J.P. Morgano.
I cannot believe DiPapa wins again.
Well, feast your eyes on it, Corelli, because Maceo Pasquale DiPapa's got his men ready. They came out there, they overcame the odds. Hey, Jesse Ventura would be happy because, as he said, win if you can, lose if you must, but always cheat. Knuckle Duster's the winner. And hey, now look, let's celebrate by kicking the crap out of DeRossi.
Hey guys, that's enough, come on. The match is over. Hey, here comes Kingdom Come.
Oh, Kingdom Come hitting the ring, and smartly, the heavyweight champion, Randy Rain. Oh, he went to higher ground, but now he got back in the ring.
Man, JP Morgado landed on Ray Bernardo, and may have...
And I don't know if the cameras caught it, but DiPapa just laying the boots to Ray Bernardo. I love it. I love it. You're right, you're still the champion. Randy Rain's still the champion. Dustin Quicksilver's still the champion. Pasquale DiPapa's still the boss. He's still the landlord. He's still the Don.
Apparently he's left-footed.
He's anti-bidextrous or whatever the hell that damn word is. What a great night here at the Ontario Super Series. We've seen the stars of Battle Art Wrestling. We've seen the stars of Destiny World Wrestling. We've seen the stars of Border City Wrestling. Anthony Pirelli, me and you never see eye to eye. But the one thing I think we can agree on is when promotions come together for the betterment of the product, the betterment of the fans, and the betterment of the business, it's good for everybody.
Absolutely. This is a snapshot of what the wonderful province of Ontario has to offer. We're just getting better as a collective. We're growing, we're maturing, we're respected all over the world. We have a great independent professional wrestling scene here in the GTA and Ontario in general.
Yeah, well, an unbelievable night here at the Ontario Super Series. What a way to end it there with Team Bernardo being losers to the Pasquale Di Papa family. So, Corelli, I've enjoyed it. I've made it better for everybody. And next time that I'm here, I won't have to sit next to your smug face, and I'll get to go back to doing what I do best, which is causing you grief.
That's always a pleasure to see you, too.
Welcome